We did have quite a bit of cloud cover around yesterday. And if you were outside in the afternoon, if you were in an area that was sheltered from the sunshine underneath those clouds, it definitely felt a lot cooler. So the littlest bit of sunshine helps us out so much. And seeing as the temperatures will eventually turn warmer this afternoon, that's going to help us out. We have winds out of the northeast at 3, very light, 51 degrees. That means wind chill is not going to be a huge factor stepping out the door first thing this morning. Humidity at 77% and the pressure is falling. Cool mornings, mild afternoons all weekend long. Next chance for rainfall on Monday looks very, very slim. It looks like central Kansas is going to have a better chance of picking up some spotty showers. But for us, just a few sprinkles. Then Thursday and a Friday, we're going to have a huge, massive, powerful cold front that's going to be moving through. Not only is it going to give us an opportunity for some rainfall, but it's also going to be a significant drop to our temperatures, not only the daytime highs, but also the overnight lows. And in fact, by the time Thursday, late Thursday and a Friday rolls around, let's just say we may be struggling to get out of the 50s for highs. 49 degrees out there right now. We've got 50 degrees in Belton, 47 in Trenton and Chillicothe, 45 in Maryville, 55 degrees in Emporia. But a difference a few states away makes. See all this cloud cover that is now inching across southern Kansas, southern Missouri? That's because of a storm system down in Texas. Notice how we don't have any cloud cover across northern Kansas nor northern Missouri. And the reason for that is because of this high pressure system. High pressure systems, the air sinks. Also, the winds coming in from the northeast supports a cooler flow for us. But down to the south of us, the storm system that is moving through Texas, drought-stricken areas getting a healthy dosage of rainfall. Thing is, with high pressure being a roadblock, it's going to keep most of the clouds. It's also going to keep all of this moisture down to the south. So Oklahoma, Texas will be able to enjoy this, and eventually it will move over toward Arkansas, Louisiana, and the rest of the deep south. 64 this morning, mostly sunny skies all day long. A few of those clouds may try to get closer to the I-70 corridor thanks to that southern track storm system by this evening. 78, a gorgeous afternoon. Winds are going to be light coming in from the northeast at 5 to 10. Tonight, northerly winds at 5 to 10, mostly clear. Skies, upper 40s. The farther north you travel, closer to 60 degrees. The farther south, including 57 degrees in Butler. Mostly sunny skies on a future scan for today. Then we start to see a few clouds by tomorrow. And here it is by Monday afternoon. That is it. That's the most moisture that future scan is painting, which could give us those spotty sprinkle chances on Monday. Mostly sunny skies return Tuesday into Wednesday. It also means a small dip in temperatures away from the 80s, both Sunday and Monday. But then here comes that cool down. You ready for it? 66 on Thursday, 60 for the high on Friday with our overnight lows in the upper 50s to start Thursday morning. But on Thursday, the temperatures will be falling, 41 going into Friday morning, and our temperatures will be in the 30s at this time next weekend.
Wow. Well, it's a nice stretch before that, yeah. So we'll try to focus on that and know that's coming at the end.
And of course, the computer models can change, but they are definitely coming into agreement that we're going to have a huge shot of colder air at the end of the work week.
All right. We'll be ready. Lisa, thanks.